Hi everyone! Welcome again sa aking channel. For this video, ang ituturo ko naman sa inyo ay yung continuation ng lessons under general mathematics. This time, it is Unit 3, which is all about inverse functions. But before we proceed to the inverse function, ang first topic ng Unit 3 is all about one-to-one functions. Let's define one-to-one function. One-to-one function is a function where each element of the domain corresponds to a unique element in its range. Ang ibig sabihin niyan is, there is a one-to-one correspondence between x and y values. Meaning to say, for every element ng domain, there is only one element ng range. Let's have examples of one-to-one function and how are we going to determine if a function is one-to-one. Example number one, determine which mapping diagram illustrate one-to-one function. Remember the concept of one-to-one function? There is one-to-one correspondence between the x value and the y value. For example, we have the first function f of x, ito yung kanyang mapping diagram, and we have another function, g of x, ito naman yung kanyang mapping diagram. Sa ating f of x, there is one-to-one correspondence because x sub 1 corresponds to y sub 1, x sub 2 corresponds to y sub 2, and x sub 3 corresponds to y sub 3. Ang ating f of x is one-to-one function. On the other hand, sa ating g of x, makikita natin na may dalawang values of x na nakakorresponds sa iisang value ng 1. Although may nakita tayong 1-to-1, yung x sub 1 corresponds to y sub 1, meron naman siyang x sub 2 na nakakorresponds sa y sub 2 at x sub 3 nakakorresponds din sa y sub 2. Ibig sabihin, ang ating g of x is not one-to-one function. That is how we identify mapping diagram if it is one-to-one function or not. Let's proceed to example number 2. Example number 2 will involve graph. In order for us to determine if a graph is one-to-one function, we will use the horizontal line test. Horizontal line test states that if any horizontal line intersects the graph exactly once, then the graph is one-to-one function. If the horizontal line intersects more than once, then it is not one-to-one function. This is the illustration of horizontal line test. Suppose meron tayong mga graph, and then we're going to imagine a horizontal line that will pass through our graph up and down. Dito sa ating kaliwa, makikita natin na laging isa lang yung intersection ng horizontal line at yung mismong graph. Therefore, our graph is one-to-one function. On the other hand, itong ating quadratic function, makikita natin na magkakaroon ng dalawang intersection yung horizontal line at yung mismong graph. Kaya ito ay not one-to-one function. Let's see the animation how we conduct the horizontal line test. Let's use the horizontal line test to answer our example number 2. Determine which graph illustrates a one-to-one function. We have letter A, ang ating function ay v of x, ito yung kanyang graph. Then we have letter B, ang ating function is h of x, ito yung kanyang graph. Using the horizontal line test, maglagay tayo ng horizontal line sa ating v of x. Makikita natin na magkakaroon ng two intersection yung horizontal line at yung graph. Therefore, ang letter A natin is not one-to-one function. On the other hand, yung ating letter B, pag naglagay tayo ng horizontal line, makikita natin na lahat ng point ay intersection ng ating horizontal line at yung mismong graph. Therefore, ang ating letter B is also not one-to-one function. Let's have letter C. Ang ating letter C, ang ating function ay C of X. Ito yung kanyang graph. Let's have a horizontal line. Makikita natin na laging isa lang yung intersection ng horizontal line sa ating graph. Therefore, ang ating letter C is a one-to-one function using the horizontal line test. This is how we conduct horizontal line test to determine if the graph is one-to-one function. Let's proceed to example number 3. Example number 3 will involve set of ordered pairs. Remember again the concept of one-to-one function. There is one-to-one correspondence between x and y values. Ibig sabihin, walang repeated values of x at wala ding repeated value of y. We have three functions here, ang ating f of x, g of x, at h of x. Let's start with f of x. F of x consists of 1, 3, 4, 2, and 5, 1. 1, 4, at 5. There is no repeated values of x. Tignan naman natin yung values of y. 3, 2, 1. There is no repeated values of y then. Therefore, ang ating f of x is a one-to-one function. Ang ating g of x naman is consist of 4, 8, 5, -1, and 6, 8. Tingnan natin yung values of x, 4, 5, at 6. There is no repeated values of x. Tingnan naman natin yung y values, 8, -1, 8. Makikita natin that there is repeated value of y, which is 8. Therefore, ang ating g of x is not one-to-one function. H of x consists of 6, 11, 7, 1, and 8, 0. Tingnan natin yung values of x, 6, 7, 8. There is no repeated values of x. Then, let's see the values of y, 11, 1, at 0. Wala ding repeated values of y. Therefore, ang ating h of x is also one-to-one function. That is how we determine the set of ordered pairs if it is one-to-one function or not. This is the end of our topic about one-to-one function. It covers the definition of one-to-one function and how are we going to determine one-to-one function from different representations. Ang susunod naman na topic is about the inverse of a function.